Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video. Hope you guys are doing well today. It's been a while, I know. And if the video has come out and I still plan to edit it or release it, whatever, there might have been a Microsoft Flight Simulator video before this, but I don't know. But I wanted to make an A320 Neo flight on my channel and fly just generally. And I know the new fly-by-wire came out with a nice update of with the new cockpit glare shield. With new glare shield, everything else is pretty much the same. It's just the glare shield that's new, so it still looks like 20 times better now. But I flew it once and I was like, yeah, it's good, but not my style because it's not good enough. And Microsoft Flight Simulator still sucks when it comes to flight model. So I'm just turned off by it. I've said this every single video that I have made a video on that wasn't MSFS, but it's the truth, and I'm sorry. Let's go ahead and get started. Master's off, most like normal. Weather radar off, predicted wind system off, gears down, wipers off. Batteries at least 25 and a half. 1, 2. Your lighting is off. External power can come on. All right, if you fire test. TCAS is normal. Normally with TCAS, you would also have the... Well, TCAS now should not be there, actually, since the RSR selected the nav, so now it shouldn't be here, but generally that would be normal. I mean, there's a lot of status messages missing. Now it's normal. There we go. We'll start with the ACARS. ATSU AOC menu. Light init. Mentor request, go receive messages, go to data, aircraft status, aircraft type is up to date, engine type, or aircraft type is correct, engine type is correct, nav database is up to date, this is fine, go to init, Vegas to Memphis, and flight number is correct for now, the rest we'll check later, aircraft acceptance, down for 3 seconds. That is checked, status is checked, circuit breakers are all pushed in, that's good, and do the preliminary performance determination, 147.8 plus 2 tons, 149.8, so we'll go 149.8. And we'll compute. Flexing 72, 1 plus F, 48, 48, 51, 218. Maximum takeoff weight of 171.1. That's checked. 3012. Is set. Oxygen is checked. Hydraulic quantities are checked. Engine oil quantities. We'll need to power the FedEx. Inspect. That's fine. Flaps up, indicating boilers are sound, parking brake set, extra pressure is not yet in the green, but it will be once the cargo doors close. And we'll request fuel. This side. Also request a low pressure air to get some air conditioning. The fuel we require is 17.5, so we'll go 17.6 request. And close. Now I'm gonna clip my charts and then we'll continue with the pre-flight procedures. Alright, so we can continue. Fueling is completed. else checks out. That looks good. All checked. All this looks good as well. It is checked. UGC is checked. That's good to go. Prince. Let your plan 190. Action tested. Plan now, but Electro's 1 and 2. That's checked. It's cross checked. One last thing we'll do actually is go to pilot routes and we'll store the active. We'll go to performance. Back to init. Alright, we'll just wait for boarding to complete and then we can continue. Alright, so loading is completed. We got the load sheet. We can continue. 0 fuel weight 130.9. 0 fuel weight center gravity of 30. Plug that in. That gives us a takeoff weight of 1481, approximately a little bit less than that. 1482. That's still all good. We're gonna go temperature 7, 10. Orient is off, compute. 72, 48, 48, 50. 48.51 within 1 knot is fine. 72 and up 0.2 to 17 is checked. Alright, so for start, beacon on, tow starts auto, parking brake set, acupressure is in the green, slides are armed, we close the cockpit door, wait for the nose wheel steering disengage memo to appear. Alright, there it is. Before start check, those parking brake on, take out speeds and thrust, 48, 48, 51, flex 72. Checks and set, windows closed, beacon is on, four star checklist is completed.
Here comes the pushback, light them up. And we're disconnecting the tow. Give me just a moment. And we're disconnected. Signal and pin on the left. Take it easy and have a safe flight.
Yep. Hand signal has been given. After start checklist, anti ice off. Not required. Again, status checked. Pitch trim 0.2 offset. Trim neutral. After start checklist complete. We'll go and do the flight control test now. Normally you do it during taxi, but I don't think the steering doesn't get disconnect works. Full down, neutral, left, full right, neutral, we'll try, full left, full right, we'll try. I think it works if you, Flight control check is completed, ready to go, parking brake release, taxi light on, and we're on our way to Memphis. TCAS runway is confirmed. TCAS TA RA packs 1 and 2 are off. Cabin has been advised. Cabin crew, see for departure. Okay, this is definitely a bug with X-Plane and stuff. Just ignore those. Clear for takeoff. Lights, camera, and action. Flex 72 SRS runway out of thrust blue. Rotate altitude. Brake gears coming up. Nav. Thrust climb, climb, auto thrust, type 1. since we're close to reaching our top of descent, we're going to go ahead and get our latest weather. The weather, runway 18 still, runway 18 left is the only one open right now, so 18 left is confirmed and checked. We can go through the routing and the restrictions. We're going to calculate our landing information, medium reverse on compute, RO go low, compute, brake low set. Everything else is checked, status, pressurization is good, and yep, we are ready to go.
Minimum.
Continue.
50, 40, 30, 20.
Retard,
10.
Five.
Thank you. Alright, parking check. Those parking breaker chocks are set. Engines off, wing lights off, fuel pumps off, fuel electric pump off. Parking checklist is completed. That was a pretty hard banger, but you know, I have to say the TOLUS 320 Neo does not really land as it should. It's a bit, it likes to fall out of the ground. It's got some weird fly-by-wire flare logic in there that causes the plane to pretty much plummet to the ground or just not flare as much as it should with the amount of stick you give it. The real 320 Neo, or at least I know the level D simulator 320 Neo flies or lands almost like any other 320 normal aircraft or CEO or traditional engine option or the classic engine option. But yeah, it's fine. We're also going to check the iris monitor. That's fine. That's checked. Fuel is also checked. Is also good. It was a nice flight, and I hope you guys enjoyed it as much as I did. I'm looking forward to some future videos with you guys, and until then, have yourselves a wonderful rest of the day, and I'm looking forward to 2024 releases. Peace!